Yo, what's going on, guys? It is Fragrance Empire. Thank you for tuning into the channel. We've got a great one today, an impromptu that I wasn't even sure I was going to be doing, but I said, you know what? I've worn this for the past 2 days. I got to let my subscribers know about this brand new juice. You probably heard about it. If you haven't, get away from that rock that you're living under. And today we're looking at Bohemian Lime. So this is the new one by Goldfield & Banks. This is the 7.5 mil decant that's provided by the company. As you can see, it's right here. And then they also have the 100 mil. So this is the nice little decant that they have. Let's see about the distribution. Nice little distribution on the 7.5 mil. And what I'm gonna let you guys know right now, right off the bat, if you like the video and you wanna try this out, I'm gonna give that 7.5 mil away to one of my subscribers. Just like, if we get 100, I'm gonna go ahead and give it away in my next video and let's talk about it a little bit. So guys, first impressions, I'm not going to go too long with this video. Like I mentioned, brand new release 2020, and I am pretty damn happy with what they did. So I'm someone who really loves that lime note. I don't really get too many fragrances that have lime that's going to be very, very prominent at the very top, and this one does the note justice. So I got to put it out there, if you are a lime fan and you love that note, you're gonna love this fragrance. And I'm gonna let you know right now, for the first hour, it is super, super prominent with the bergamot up on top. After, I would say about maybe 2 hours into the fragrance, you're gonna get a heavy dose of the vetiver that's gonna be in there. I would say trickling in the background at the very beginning stages, but then it gets more prominent toward that 2 hour mark. The other great thing about this fragrance is it's got a nice amber accord as well. So once it's dried down, the lime note kind of distinguishes itself and puts itself in the background, but then you got that vetiver and then you got that amber note that's more prominent with a nice sandalwood with cedarwood. So if you like lime, amber, cedarwood, sandalwood, if you like bergamot, you're gonna absolutely love this fragrance. And the great thing about this fragrance, I swear, is it doesn't remind me of a lot of other fragrances that are on the market, which is a great thing. So I'm a huge fan of lime, like I mentioned, so I absolutely do enjoy the fragrance at the very top with that vetiver, which isn't that stanky vetiver. It's super, super wearable. Great, like a great release for the summer of 2020. What else can I tell you about the fragrance? When we're talking about projection, it's gonna sit a little bit more closer to the skin. It's not one that's super, super loud, and I'm not looking for that with this fragrance. But with the projection, I'm getting about 2 feet where people are able to smell it. And they're able to smell it, I would say, for about 4 hours in. So 4 hours of projection, about 2 feet in distance, and longevities, I can't believe it, guys. So this is my second day wearing it. Yesterday, I could still smell the fragrance where it's not getting that olfactory fatigue where I wasn't even able to smell it anymore. I'm getting about 7 hours. So 4 hours of projection, 7 hours of longevity. It's a great release, great freshie, one that doesn't really put itself out there to remind myself of anything that's out on the market. It's a little odd because I was talking to my brothers the other day, and I feel like I get that Ambroxan note in a way of Sauvage at the very beginning stages, but then it kind of puts itself away. There's no Ambroxan in the fragrance itself, but I still get the little bit of that whiffs of Sauvage in a way, and I think it's because of that amber or that vetiver mixed in with the lime. So again, guys, if you like those kind of fragrances, you're looking for a brand new release, something that's gonna be great for 2020 summer, I think it's gonna be a great staple in people's collections if they're looking for an all-around fragrance that you could wear dress up, dress down, night in, night out, doesn't matter. I think it's a great date night fragrance as well. Super, super wearable when it comes to, I believe it's a unisex fragrance for myself. I can see both men and women rocking it. One that's great for myself, so it leans a little bit more masculine, but it doesn't mean that it isn't gonna fit a lady if she wants to wear the fragrance. So again, ladies, if you want to try this out, I highly suggest it. Get it, put it on your radar. Let me know what you guys think. Again, Bohemian Lime by Goldfield & Banks, brand new release for 2020. Great summer fragrance that I need to get a bottle of, like a big ass 100 mil, probably 200 mils of this juice, because it's just super damn good. So with my rating, I'm going to rate this fragrance probably like a 9.5 out of 10. I really do enjoy the fragrance. It sits well on my skin. It lasts a pretty damn long time for being a fresh fragrance for that summertime. But again, like I said, you can wear it whenever you want. It's not going to be overbearing. You could wear it for the office, you could wear it for the nights out, and it's not gonna be super loud. So guys, let me know what you guys think. Bohemian Lime, 9 out of 5 out of 10. I'm gonna give this the decant away because I'm gonna get myself a brand new damn 100 mil juice bottle, guys. So again, guys, I appreciate it. If you like what you heard, please leave a like button, hit the like button, leave your comments, and subscribe if you're already not subscribed. Until next time, guys, myself and your guys' decant of Bohemian Lime are out. Peace.